she wanted to do Matthew McKenzie of Ready Teddy. And again, Ready Teddy was the first group that sort of come out of the box, and they were the first group to have an album. So at least I had some material. So of course, Linda didn't have any questions. Miss Lynn of the Boston Group News, she doesn't come up with the questions. I come up with the questions. Because, and you know, I figure I'm gonna be embarrassed, you know, if this interview doesn't go well. So I come up with the questions, whatever. We go to their house, which is called Kilsyth Manor, which is now a legendary piece of what you call tales are out there. It was a Boston band house, one of the original Boston band houses, and surely the first punk Boston band house. It was in Brookline near BU somewhere. And it was a big Victorian that they had, I think, a whole floor, although I can't imagine anyone else living in there. And again, someone coming, this plain Paul, I'm living a pretty straight life. I walk into this band house. It was crazy. You know, all sorts of people, filth, you know, garbage all around, you know, food on the floor, you know, amps and guitars all over the place. And there's Matthew McKenzie with his girlfriend at the time, Nikki Laser, who was pretty insane. So I'm meeting these, really, the people I'm meeting are crazed, insane, and there is drugs involved, although I'm not sure whether this time there was, but that was always in the mix somewhere. And that interview actually went very, very good. I cannot believe that. That was, Matthew McKenzie thought it was great, and I thought it was great. We got a lot of good stories out of him. We got a good, you know, interview in the Creepy News. And the beauty of that is Matthew is dead now. And if you read that interview, you can hear his voice. And that's, to me, is one of the greatest things. Nowhere else, well, he has his album, so you hear him there. But you really hear who he is and what he cared about in that interview. So I'm very proud of that.